Hey there, it's Mateo. Here's a little bit something different. Before we get started, I want to let you know a little bit more about me. One of my passions is the study of ancient civilizations and mankind from our past. One of my main goals since I was a kid was trying to find physical evidence to support the ancient texts and oral traditions of this amazing world. This is actually one of the drivers that led me into the Marine Corps and further into understanding how to live in the wilderness. I concluded that the longer I stayed in hard-to-reach areas of this world, the higher chance I'd have to discover the ancient past. I have been cultivating these skill sets for a very long time, and wouldn't you know it, they paid off by finding some unrecognized cities in Iraq and being one of the first Westerners to document and see the remains of lost kingdoms in Afghanistan along the Silk Road. What I was not prepared for was that these skill sets would also lead to a confrontation with an unknown and highly intelligent species that happened to be a lot closer than I ever imagined. Having run-ins with this hominid species known as Sasquatch has diverted a lot of my attention and focus for now. It's not like I could just ignore a 10-foot giant lurking in my backyard. The search for truth will always bring me back looking for more. Knowing that, I still love to dabble in the ancient past and find potential leads to sync legend with evidence. I still have a lot of exploring to do, and once this chapter of my life with Sasquatch has come to a conclusion, I plan to start off where I left off, looking for signs and truths of the ancient past. Here is one of those clues that may suggest evidence of a global culture 8,000 years ago. What the genetic examinations tell us is that 8,000 years ago, there were on average 17 women to one man globally. In the article, the Pacific Standard, a computational biologist makes it clear this was not due to a mass death of males. Another member of the research team, a biological anthropologist, hypothesized that somehow only a few men accumulate lots of wealth and power, leaving nothing for the others. Let's stop for a moment and consider what the results show, and some of the conclusions experts are drawing from this study. What is being suggested is that leading up to 8,000 years ago, a global culture was in control, in which something akin to hereditary male monarchs were in power for thousands of years, creating a large gap between men reproducing with women. This is the physical evidence needed to support many oral and ancient written records of a time when everyone was one, the age of the gods, and why we see so many archetypes and stories played out over and over again globally. This could potentially be the smoking gun that brings more reality to the great civilizations that may have existed, like Atlantis. Pushing the envelope even further, was this the making of a global culture adopted from one mother culture, or are we witnessing something even bigger? The evidence could suggest a powerful global civilization that existed thousands of years ago, which may have reached across the globe that allowed the select few from each locale to obtain genetic dominance for thousands of years. There's no way to prove how much or how this culture may have taken shape, but the archaeological evidence is starting to paint a picture around that time frame, like Göbekli Tepe. A lot of this is conjecture, but what we do have is hard evidence, and that evidence is in the code. It clearly shows a genetic power gap that, until a better hypothesis is brought forward, shows that globally a select few around the same time held immense power. This begs the question, as the research team suggested, that 8,000 years ago, a powerful culture took hold. Asking the question and speculating on the answers is luckily something we can do here without harm. The male drop rates start around 10,000 years ago, occurring around the end of the last ice age, which geology is showing us was a devastating time for all life on Earth. Perhaps we are seeing a new culture erupting from the chaos of the Younger Dryas. The question is, who was the mother culture and where did it come from? Was this the age of the gods, lasting for thousands of years before being toppled over? If I were to guess based on the chart, I'd say somewhere between 5 and 6,000 years ago is when this male to female gap changes. I would also go further to guess that this was due to insurrection and rebellion for power from an extractive culture, that if the interpretation of the genetic results is correct, had kept power within the small group globally for thousands of years. I don't know how else to say this. This is super exciting. We have physical evidence to support oral and rich nation histories around the world, a time when a group of elites were worshipped as gods, where the rest of humanity toiled and worked in the fields for them. The fall of Eden, when the people had enough of this extractive system. Again, the rest of this is speculation and conjecture on my part, but this genetic evidence is one big solid piece that is not going away. It's here to stay, and it will force us to look deeper and further into our past and recognize the reality of our ancient and rich in oral histories. I will keep you updated on the more I learn that could provide more solid evidence to better help shape and build this ancient legacy of mankind. Please like, subscribe, and turn on notifications to know when new videos are up. If you'd like to support the channel even more, then become a member. Thank you for watching.